This question's from the 2015 exam. It's a type 2 problem because we're talking about velocity and acceleration. I've also classified it as type 5 because we're doing calculus off of a table. Question 1 says, use the data in the table to evaluate or estimate, I should say, v prime of 16. So this is saying, what is the slope of velocity, i.e. what is acceleration of 16? Because we don't have an equation, we're using the table, and 16 is not on the table, so we use the two closest points and do an average rate of change. So the average rate of change of velocity, we use the two closest points to 16. Equals 5. And our unit here in the table for velocity is meters per minute. Meters per minute. And because we're doing an average rate of change of velocity, it's going to be meters per minute squared. Now, they didn't ask for the unit on that, so it's okay if you don't have the unit, but you have to show the difference quotient. So that difference quotient supports the work, but it is only 1 point for having the correct answer of 5. Remember, no floating answers. You can't just say 5. You have to have the work that supports that answer. Moving on to part B. Part B says, using correct units, explain the meaning of the integral 0 to 40 absolute value v of t dt. So this is the total distance traveled by Joanna from t equals 0 minutes to t equals 40 minutes in meters. Okay. What is happening? When is it happening? You have to include the units of minutes, and you have to include the units of meters. Now, they did not ask this question, but one of the most common mistakes is confusing this with total displacement. So these are two different questions. They only ask you the upper one, but I'm writing them down. With the absolute value, you're talking about total distance, and you will always have a non-negative answer. If you do not have an absolute value, that's displacement or accumulation, and it is possible to have a negative answer. So, absolute value, always non-negative, i.e. zero or positive. Then they want you to actually go through the process of approximating it using a right Riemann sum with four subintervals. So when we look at the table, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 subintervals. So our table supports the idea of 4 subintervals. Zero to 40, absolute value v of t is approximated by RRAM4. So we're doing right Riemann approximation method with 4 subintervals. Our first rectangle has a height of 200 meters and a width of 12 minutes. Our second rectangle, when we do the right-hand side, is a height of 240 and a width of 8 units. Our third rectangle has a height of positive 220. Because we're doing absolute value of velocity. So a positive 220 with a width of 4. And our last rectangle has a height of 150 with a width of 16. If you were to add these up, you get a total of 7,600 meters. 7,600 meters is 7.6 kilometers, which is, I don't know, what, four-ish miles? Four or five miles? I'm really bad at converting. 40 minutes, is that good? It's a decent pace, I think. I don't know. Don't trust that 4 miles number. Well, you multiply by 0.6, 7.6 times 0.6. Yeah, 4.5 miles in 40 minutes. That's like a 9 minute mile. That's not too bad. That's a good jogging pace. Healthy Joanna, good for her. She should run a marathon.
Call me next Tuesday, hey! You there, what? Hey, what? There, where? Yeah. Hey, you there, there, hey, there, there. Oh. Hey, you there, okay. I see you over there. One time I want you, don't come here. Sit down.
So then the points for this, you get 1 point if you had the explanation correct. You get 1 point if you did the right Riemann sum, and then 1 point if you have the correct final answer. On to part C. Bob is riding his bicycle along the same path from 0 to 10. Bob's velocity is modeled by B of T, where T is measured in minutes. Find Bob's acceleration. So part C, they want us to find B prime of 5. Since this is a non-calculator question, we want to do this without the calculator. B prime of, oops, not X, B prime of T is 3T squared minus 12T. And then B prime of 5, we plug 5 into that and we get 75 minus 60, which is 15. Still traveling in meters per minute, and because we are calculating acceleration, meters per minute squared. This is worth 2 points. 1 point if you found B prime of T, recognizing that that represents acceleration, and 1 point if you successfully evaluated it at time 5. And part D. Based on the model from B, find Bob's average velocity. Average velocity. Well, we have a velocity function, so we just need to do average function value of our velocity function. So there's our go-to average function value. For us, we are doing 10 minus 0 of the velocity function, which is B of T dt. Okay. That's 1/10 the antiderivative of B of T evaluated from 0 to 10. So T to the 4th over 4 minus 6T cubed over 3 plus 300 T evaluated from 0 to 10. When you clean this out, you get 1/10 times 10,000 fourths minus 2,000 plus 3,000, which equals an average velocity of 350 meters per minute. That's what is that? 1/3 of a kilometer, which is 1/4 mile in a minute. That's a pretty fast pace. Maybe I did some rough approximations there off. Again, I hate these conversions. Anyways, be sure to comment, like, subscribe, hit that bell for notifications, ask good questions, conquer the world. Peace out. Oh, 1 point for the integral. 1 point for the integral. 1 point for the antiderivative. And 1 point for the answer.
Outro 2.0.
Ask good questions, conquer the world. Peace out.